Hello and greetings from Iceland. My second volcano tour to capture eruption number 11 came to an end yesterday after I had spent over 20 days in Reykjavík and Grindavík or two separate trips in order to capture the beginning of the eruption that we have been waiting for. And it is therefore only a formality to tell you that it is overdue. And that is my main concern, of course. Will the next eruption be larger than the lava berms can handle? Because there is already more magma under there than before the November eruption. And the lava berms, they could just barely hold that one back. And every day, with this inflating and overdue magma storage under there, increases the likelihood of uncontrollable situation. So we want this over and done with, as soon as possible, of course. We have already filled our surprise quota, at least for this part of Iceland. But this tour of mine, it was, however, better than I expected for other reasons than I expected. So I'm going to talk a bit about my travel story last week and show you some videos, of course. And like many good tours, it didn't start well because the weather was just miserable when I arrived to Reykjavík. Just before two nasty storms, the first one ruined the weekend, but the Met Office, they promised me a few good hours of a low wind and good visibility Monday afternoon or before the next storm would hit us. So I took off to Grindavík with the intention to film the critters close up. I've done it several times before, so this tour was to capture videos in order to see how they developed through those frequent eruptions up there. But that day, Monday, it was impossible to even take off. And that meant only one thing. I had to remove the Met Office from my Christmas card list. It literally blew me away how poor forecast they made this time. So the only option I had left that day was to film something sarcastic like the weather. So I drove along the harsh south coast to a nice sightseeing spot. Many tourists are actually under the impression that we made this platform for them, but this is in fact free entertainment for the locals, while Mother Nature gives the tourists a free nature bath. But the weather was so dull this day that the tourists didn't even show up. And this is a clip from last year. So I got even more sarcastic and drove to one of the ugliest towns in Iceland. My last attempt that day to try to find something interesting, since this volcano tour didn't start that well, and the shots I got there, they will likely end up on my little Icelandic channel. So I'm leaving a link to it, and Monday didn't do much for me. And on Tuesday, the weather was even worse. But I drove to Grindavík again, anyway. And this time, I used an old Icelandic food tradition as an excuse to visit the Fisherman Diner in Grindavík, where I got myself a big dish with salted lamb meat, with potatoes and root vegetables, and a soup made from yellow split peas and carrots, and of course some bacon to make it extra healthy. And the lamb was good enough that no one would have noticed if the warning sirens would have gone off during lunchtime. It takes more than a volcano to interrupt a meal like this. And I felt a bit like at home, and this was my home for several years. Because I used to come here to work during many fishing seasons when I was in my 20s. So I have many good memories from here. But sadly, that community that used to be, it does no longer exist here, since the people are scattered around the country now. But there are, however, several hundred people that work here every day. Most of them live elsewhere on the peninsula, and there are somewhere around 50 houses occupied right now. Many of the local people, they want to move back full time, and the local administration, they opened the local office again just yesterday. That office has been in Reykjavík since November 2023, and that transfer of the office is symbolic for the fact that there is no giving up around here. And I keep on getting the question, why do people want to move back to a place like this? And I did a little video so to answer that question. This is the rough sea by the south coast, just outside the Grindavík harbour, where we have some of the best fishing grounds in Iceland, and good harbours by the south coast. We don't have many of them, and they are not just about to bring home the catch of the day. This is also about safety. And the Grindavik Harbor, it has gradually been modified to this excellent shelter that won't be replaced with money if lava flows over this. And I returned to Grindavik again on Wednesday. The weather was a bit better, not perfect as for documentary clarity when I'm often going after details, but instead I got something like this, the drama version, and I'm only showing a little part of it now. I will make a longer version with the music and scenes like this, they are best enjoyed in that format. But my drone complained the whole time while I was shooting this. The wind warnings, the drone told me every 2-3 minutes that it wanted to go home. And I finally flew it back to the car, but not until the battery could barely get it back. So I replaced the battery and took off again. Into even worse weather where I captured scenes like this that actually made my day. And after my return from the craters, I kept on driving around and it caught my attention how much steam was coming up from the old eruption site on the mountain Faradalsfjall where the first three eruptions took place. So I decided to do a little time-lapse documentation that can be excellent to notice anomalies. And I had prior to this noticed black smoke coming up from time to time. And I finished this visit shooting several time lapses from the drone. I'm not sure if they will do anything for me. And during my Thursday trip to Grindavik, I was getting excellent light from time to time. So I was filming wide angles of the town that I had actually filmed before. And I was also filming the old town, the remains, that are on the edge of this old lava spit and overall just filming the landscape changes. So this day left me with good material for a video about the history of the town. And the last flight of the day was with the thermal drone. That video is already online. I did detect one spot there that needed more attention. So I did another trip with the thermal drone the morning after, Friday morning. And that trip confirmed that the sun was teasing me. But I had other more important excuse to be there because there was an earthquake swarm going on by Lake Klevarvatn. So things were getting a bit more tense. And I realized that this might be my last chance to film a fracture that had been on my list for a while. It's close by the abandoned greenhouse at the other side of the lava berm. And this fracture has to do with the steam explosions that occurred during one of the eruptions last summer. I've seen it numerous times during my high angle tours, but the close-up shots I got now, I am going to make them into a separate video. And after this, I found myself a new takeoff spot to fly up to the crater that is a part of the new landscape in Grindavík. And I've filmed around it numerous times before. And since the sun was shining every now and then, I wanted to capture it before the eruption would start in order to document how it has developed. And that was when I captured something that justified this trip completely, or this vortex or whirlpool. And I actually flew up there twice for this, since this was changing the whole time, the form of this phenomena. Like this scene, all it needs is a candy floss stick. So I had lots of fun with this. And I returned from Grindavík quite pleased with what was on my memory cards. And the day after, Saturday, the Krýsuvík earthquakes was my main task. I have actually flown over there numerous times before. So I already had a good amount of footage from there. But I can always use more. And one of my tasks was to see if I could detect any changes in a hot spring that came into being only 100 years ago, because it is above a fracture that has been shaking. And I was also shooting scenes for a separate video about those earthquakes there alone, or places of interest and such. And during this whole tour, the seismic activity by Grindavík was very low. But on Sunday, the media asked one of our experts, Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson, what he felt about this. And his reply was simple. The eruption will start on March 20th. And that is when I decided that I'm going to trust him and drive home. and if this fine professor fails, I'm sending him a fuel bill, and lucky me, the weather was good yesterday, so I used the trip back north to do a longer road than usual to capture a video for the tourist section of my channel that has actually a good amount of geology content, and this is just a teaser from my filming yesterday. Those basalt columns, they will be in a separate video. And when I woke up this morning, I heard the news that the earthquake activity is picking up. So I started to think, was it a mistake to drive north? So I took the car to the car wash. I could hardly see out the windows after 100 kilometers on gravel roads yesterday. And I have emptied all memory cards. I'm charging all batteries now. And if I see that I will get a chance to film the beginning of the eruption, I will try to take off soon enough to do so. But if this starts in the middle of the night, that will be complicated. And this eruption that hasn't started has been extremely complicated and time-consuming and expensive to deal with. While my channel suffers a bit because parts of my work cannot be done while I'm in Reykjavík. But that's just how it is, and I'm just hoping now that the next eruption will be the last one. Although we do expect that when this chapter is over, the activity will move to another location on the peninsula. So I can fully admit that I'm extra worried about the town now, because we have gone through all this preparation and work, 7 eruptions near the town. And if this turns out to be the last eruption, like many of the experts expect, it would be a devastating blow if that eruption would cause more harm than the town can handle as for rebuilding it. We remain hopeful. That's all we can do. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the Volcano Island, Iceland.